This production of Madama Butterfly has some of the most magical lighting in the entire Met repertory. In fact, this is the rare production where the lights are actually part of the scenery. Here to explain is John Froelich, the Met's resident lighting designer. Hi, John.
How are you today?
I'm very well, thanks. How are you?
I'm doing all right.
Great. The opening tableau of this production, they're so beautiful. Can you tell us a bit about the role of the moving lights that rise and lower in view of the audience, what they're meant to accomplish?
Well, other than the wonderful performers on stage, I would say it's pretty much the most reliant physical element in the mm-hmm. the piece. Basically, overhead, as the performers are singing their wonderful moments on stage, are 10 moving lights. Mm-hmm. As you can see, they have a lot of different attributes between color, pan, tilt, and then on top of that, in their complexity alone, we've added long tail down pipes, about 30 feet long, and then they move in pan as well. So.
That's very cool. Well, how does the lighting that is, it was originally designed by Peter Mumford, how does it help convey the emotional arc of the story?
Oh, I think it basically, starts right off at the beginning to tell you that it's a tragedy. Mm-hmm. And then all the major moments, especially the musical moments, there are very, very powerful shifts in color mm-hmm. that help the audience understand, especially what Cho-Cho-San is going through.
Right.
It's really amazing.
One of my favorite elements of this set and of this production is this huge mirror above the stage. Can you tell us how that factors in?
Oh, the mirror itself is quite an amazing lighting element in and of itself, because there's this idea of what's going on stage and the reflection and kind of the shadow play in itself, mm-hmm. puppeteers, and then how they react with the performers and the double images sometimes you can see.
Right.
It feels quite infinite at times. It's just absolutely stunning.
It really is stunning. It's really one of my favorite things about the production. Your title is Met Resident Lighting Designer.
It's what very big.
It is a very impressive title.
Thank you.
What exactly does that entail?
Basically, within the season, there are a myriad of productions, as you well know. Mm-hmm. All 26, I basically oversee the lighting design, which is the artistic side of it. I work really closely with all the electricians to make sure we keep the production value quite high, mm-hmm. which is representative of what we do here.
Well, it's very clear that the production value is very high here, and thank you for that. Yeah. How did you get into this line of work in the first place? Did you sort of think, I'm 5 years old, what do I want to be when I grow up? This?
No, I wanted to be a helicopter pilot.
It's almost the same, though.
Yeah, it's totally
well done.
The same. It's absolutely the same. So after that fell through, I came to the stage. But actually, you know, it takes a lot of help mm-hmm. and a lot of hard work to get to a place like this, I'm sure you know.
No.
And it's the same for everybody backstage here. So it's just my passion now, and I absolutely love it.
Well, it's an amazing team that you have here. But from a lighting perspective, of the other shows that you have worked on this season, what are some of your favorites?
Well, Butterfly has a special place, especially this production, has a special place
right.
in my heart. But basically, Richard Eyre's Verte mm-hmm. is also another one that's absolutely quite visually stunning. And of course, you can't ever forget about La Boheme or Turandot. It's
no.
absolutely just icons of what we do.
Mm. So, well, amazing. John, I thank you so much. Thank you for lighting the Met. Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.